This video is on design of shaft coupling. This topic is from the course Design of Machine Element being offered in fourth semester of P&I Engineering program at Rajasthan Technical University. First, what is the application of the shaft coupling? What for we use it? You can see in the image below, there is a motor and pump. These two are manufactured in different industries, and to use them together, we have to couple them. For that, we use shaft coupling. So here you can see, this is the shaft coupling. Apart from this, it has many other applications, like a generator joined to diesel engine, compressor driven by motor, and there are many more. So many requirements are to be satisfied for a good shaft coupling. It should be easy to assemble and disassemble. It should hold the shaft in proper alignment. Should be able to reduce or absorb the shocks. Should not have any projecting part, otherwise it may harm the others in case of breakage of the bolts. And above all, it should be able to transmit power from one shaft to another shaft without any losses. Broadly, there are two types of shaft coupling: rigid coupling and flexible coupling. Rigid coupling is used to join the shaft whose axes are perfectly aligned. There are various types of rigid coupling: muff coupling, split muff coupling, and flange coupling. The flexible coupling is used where the axes of the two shafts have lateral misalignment, axial misalignment, or angular misalignment. Again, there are many types of flexible coupling: bush pin type coupling, universal coupling, Oldham coupling. But here in this video, we'll discuss the design of three coupling as per the course: muff coupling, flange coupling, bush pin type coupling. You can see here a muff coupling. There are two shafts. They are joined with the help of muff. This hollow cylindrical part is muff. The two shafts are connected to this muff through keys. When power is, there is one we can call input shaft, another output shaft. When power is transmitted from input to an output shaft through key and this muff. In the process, this shaft and muff, they are subjected to torque. So this is another version of muff coupling where muff is used in two halves. You can see the upper half and lower half here in different colors, and these two halves are joined with the help of nut and bolts. This split muff coupling is used when the machines which are to be joined, they are very heavy. This is the sectional view of muff coupling. You can see it is in upper half in section. Various dimensions are shown here: small d, diameter of shaft, capital D, outside diameter of muff, L, length of muff. We already discussed about this. So there are three parts as we have discussed in the muff coupling: shaft, sleeve, and key. And through the design procedure, we have to obtain their various dimensions: diameter of shaft, outer diameter of sleeve or muff, length of sleeve or muff, and different dimensions of key. Whenever any coupling is to be designed, it is specified how much power it can transmit and speed of rotation. Using power and speed of rotation, we can find out the torque which is to be transmitted by the coupling. Next, we have to choose material for each part. There are guidelines available how to choose the material. Beginner can refer those guidelines, and from the material properties tables we can find out their strength, and using factor of safety we can obtain the permissible stresses. Sometimes you are given permissible stresses directly. Now, whenever we have to design any mechanical system which consists of number of parts, to find the load on each and every part, we have to get their free body diagram so we can identify what load is coming on each part. So first we take up the design of shaft. This is a very simple case of shaft design. Shaft is subjected to pure torque, which induces torsional shear stress in it, and maximum shear stress is given by this expression. And for designing, we equate this maximum shear stress to the permissible stress, and using this equation we can find out diameter of shaft. Next part is muff. So in muff design, initially we choose the various dimensions using the standard proportions. Capital D is taken as 2D plus 13, and length L is taken as 3.5 diameter. As we discussed earlier, the muff, which is a hollow cylinder, is subjected to torque. And in the hollow cylinder, the maximum shear stress is given by this expression. And because we know all these parameters involved in this equation, we can calculate tau max here. And we have to check that this tau max is less than tau permissible. If it comes out to be greater, we have to redesign it, increase the capital D, again check it till this condition is satisfied. Here the tau permissible is for the muff material we have to take. Last part is key. Now the key is usually made in two parts. One part is in one shaft, another part joins the another shaft with the muff. So capital L is the length of muff. The length of key in each shaft is 1/2 of this. Now key is mounted on the circumference of the shaft, so first we have to identify what is the force coming on the key, and this force is equal to the tangential force acting at the circumference of the shaft, which can be calculated by this simple expression. As the key is sunk in both the shaft and the sleeve or muff, this tangential force causes shear and crushing stress in the key. In this slide, you can get the more insight. So this is the shaft subjected to torque T. This is where the key is mounted. So on the circumference, this is the tangential force acting here, and this part of the key is inside the hub, and there is a reaction from the hub on this portion of the key. So due to this set of forces, we on this plane shear stresses are induced, and also where the Shaft and key are in direct contact. This force causes crushing here. There is a direct contact between key and the muff, so this part is also subjected to crushing stress. In this figure you can see, if the key fails at all, this is how it is going to fail in shear. The upper part, between upper end part, lower part, there is a sliding. And the shear area you can see is the width and the length of the key. And this shows that this is the shaded area, or this hatched area is the area of crushing. Key design is again very simple. First we consider the shearing of the key. This is the shear area, width into length. Then we find the stresses in the shear, that is force upon area. And we equate this stresses with the permissible stress. And using this design equation, we can find out the width of the key. Here tau permissible we have to use is for the key material. Next we consider the crushing of the key. This is the crushing area, half the thickness into length of the key. We find crushing stresses, force upon area. Equate this crushing stress with the permissible crushing stress. Using this equation, we can find out the thickness of the key. Here, important thing to note, the permissible crushing stress we have to take minimum of shaft, sleeve and key material, because all these three are under crushing. So this way we can find out all the dimensions of the muff coupling. In next video we will talk about design of flange coupling and flexible.